Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about Obelia. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding about characteristic features of Obelia, its life cycle consisting of the polyp colony representing the asexual stage and the medusa representing the sexual stage. Let us begin with the introduction to Obelia. Obelia is a genus of marine colonial invertebrates belonging to the phylum Cnidaria and class Hydrozoa. Obelia forms delicate fur-like colonies and are therefore commonly known as sea fur. It is cosmopolitan in distribution and occur widely in temperate and tropical marine environment. It is found attached to seaweeds, submerged roots, and shells. Obelia is a dioecious organism with distinct sexual and asexual life stages. It exhibits dimorphism and metagenesis with a sessile or sedentary polyp stage and a free-swimming sexual medusa stage. Now, let us learn the taxonomic classification of Obelia. Obelia belongs to kingdom Animalia, phylum Cnidaria, class Hydrozoa, order Leptothecata, family Campanulariidae, and genus Obelia. Next, let us understand the characteristic features of Obelia. Obelia has tissue organization and is radially symmetrical. The organism is diploblastic with outer ectoderm layer and inner endoderm layer. There is a jelly-like substance between the two layers known as mesogliae or mesenchyma. Obelia is carnivorous with holozoic mode of nutrition. Digestion is partly extracellular and partly intracellular. It shows the presence of a gastrovascular cavity. A brain or ganglia is absent in Obelia, but it possesses a simple nerve net. Stinging cells called nidoblasts are present on the body surface and tentacles, which inject hypnotoxin into prey and paralyze it. Each polyp serves a specific function. Polyps with tentacles are used for feeding and capturing prey. Reproductive polyps produce medusae, which are the sexual reproductive structures, and defensive polyps give protection against predators. Respiration and excretion occur by diffusion through the general body surface. The polyp stage reproduce asexually by budding, while the medusa stage reproduce sexually. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, let us learn about the polyp colony, which represents the asexual stage of Obelia. The polyp colony or hydroid is a branched sessile structure attached to the substrate. It consists of a horizontal thread-like root called hydrorhiza, which anchors the colony to the substrate. From hydrorhiza, arises a vertical branching stem known as hydrocollus. It bears zooids or polyps on either side. The ultimate branch terminates in a nutritive zooid called hydranth. Reproductive polyps called blastostyles are present near the base of the hydrocollus in the axis of the polyps. The polyps are interconnected by a tubular structure called the cnosarc and are protected by a tough chitinous exoskeleton called the perisarc. The cnosarc consists of the ectoderm, mesoglia, and endoderm through which a continuous gastrovascular cavity runs. There are different types of polyps. Hydranth or nutritive polyps possess tentacles and mouth. Tentacles bear nidocytes, which are responsible for capturing, ingesting, and digesting food for the whole colony. Gonangia or reproductive polyps are cylindrical in shape and are enclosed in a transparent protective case known as gonotheca. These reproductive polyps contain blastostyle that bears several medusa buds. Now, let us understand the asexual mode of reproduction. In Obelia, polyps reproduce asexually by budding. Budding produces new feeding polyps or hydrants or gastrozoids, and new reproductive polyps or gonozoids or blastostyles. Gonozoids are club-shaped and lack mouth and tentacles. They produce small bell-shaped medusa buds which develop within a protective casing called the gonotheca. When mature, they detach from the blastostyle and escape into water through an opening called the gonopore and become free-swimming medusae. Thus, the asexual polyp generation gives rise to the sexual medusae. Next is the medusa, which is the sexual stage of Obelia. The medusa is a tiny, bell-shaped or umbrella-shaped free-swimming organism. It represents the sexual stage of Obelia's life cycle. The body consists of a convex outer surface known as ex-umbrella and a concave inner surface known as sub-umbrella. The organism is radially symmetrical, diploblastic, with an outer epidermis, inner gastrodermis, and middle gelatinous non-cellular layer, the mesoglia. Medusa possesses a short tubular structure, the manubrium, that hangs from the center of the inner surface and bears a mouth at its tip. Mouth leads into the stomach. Four radial canals and a circular canal forms the gastrovascular system, which helps in digestion and circulation of food. Tentacles with nidocytes encircle the margin and are used in defense mechanism and in capturing the prey. At the base of the tentacles are the statocysts, which act as balancing organ, and ocelli, which are the light-sensitive spots. Medusa possesses a rudimentary, insignificant vellum, which is a thin, circular, inward-projecting fold of tissue from the bell margin. It helps in jet propulsion during swimming. Medusae are unisexual or dioecious organisms showing separate male and female individuals. Four gonads are present along the radial canals. They are either testes in males or ovaries in females. The medusa produces gametes, male individuals release sperms, and the female release eggs into water. External fertilization takes place, forming a zygote. The zygote divides repeatedly to form a solid ball of cells called a morula, which develops into a blastula with an internal cavity called blastocoele. Blastula undergoes gastrulation to form a solid gastrula, which develops into a free-swimming ciliated planula larva. Later, planula settles on a substrate and undergoes metamorphosis into a new polyp known as hydrula. Hydrula, by asexual budding, produce lateral buds which grow and form Obelia colony. Different types of polyps, namely feeding polyps and reproductive polyps, develop in the colony. Reproductive polyps asexually produce new medusa buds. These buds get detached and are released into water. The free-swimming medusa stage completes the life cycle of Obelia. The life cycle of Obelia is characterized by both asexual and sexual mode of reproduction. The polyp colony represents the asexual phase. It contains both feeding and reproductive polyps. The reproductive polyps reproduce asexually by budding and produce medusa buds. These buds, on maturation, gets detached from the colony and develop into free-swimming medusae. Medusa represents the sexual phase in the life cycle of Obelia. Medusae are dioecious, that is, they are either male or female and reproduce sexually by producing gametes. Eggs and sperms, which are released into the water, undergo external fertilization. A zygote is formed, which develops into a ciliated planula larva. The larva swims for a short period of time, then gets attached to a substrate and metamorphoses into a new polyp, which grows and forms a new colony. Thus, Obelia's life cycle demonstrates dimorphism and metagenesis between asexual diploid polyp generation and sexual diploid medusa generation. So today, we have learnt in detail about characteristic features of Obelia, its life cycle consisting of polyp colony representing the asexual stage and the medusa representing the sexual stage. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comments section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comment section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.